Hey guys, it's Marina with Cyclical Thought, and today I'm going to be sharing with you my farm/garden bullet journal. So this journal is not the traditional brand that I use, it's just a journal I had lying around, and I collaged on the front of it. I actually did this a couple of years ago, but I wanted to update the cover a little bit because I didn't like it too much anymore, so I'll insert a clip of it before. So I just ended up taking my boyfriend got me this booklet that had a whole bunch of pictures of fairies in it, which was absolutely beautiful, but I would get a lot more use out of the beautiful artwork if I'm seeing it every day instead of having to thumb through a book. So I cut up part of those pictures and then made a cover out of it. And I just put washi tape to like kind of glue it all to the actual book hard cover. There's a little bunny. Anyway, I don't know for the life of me who this artist is. But it's kind of etheric and a little bit creepy. I don't know. I kind of like it though. But yeah, so that's the front and back of it. I'm still going to put like, I don't know, farm journal or garden journal on the front of it, but I don't know how I'm going to do that yet. So we shall see. So this panel was originally from a birthday card that my boyfriend got. So I was like, oh, this is way too cool. Do whatever makes you happy. So I decided to put it in here so I see it all the time. It's nice to have the little pockets. And so for this bullet journal, I'm planning on just having it be all farming, all garden stuff all the time to make it easy to reference year to year. Previously, I had done a system where I had it inside my normal daily bullet journal, and that didn't really work because it just made it too difficult to thumb through, and I've already done like a whole bunch of bullet journals, so, you know, finding the right bit of information became a pain in the butt. So, this is just going to be my farm journal, and I'm going to have a table of contents just going page by page. I'm leaving this space for that as well. Then I'm going to have a collections page, and essentially these are going to be the pages that are informational based on the research that I do. So if there's a pest I see and I research it or draw it or whatever, I'll dedicate a page to that, and then I'll put it underneath the pest pages section. And then for each month, I'm going to be having a harvest log, a to-do list with a little small calendar, and then expenses right next to the harvest log, and a temperature log graph. Hopefully. We'll see. That might be too time intensive, so we'll see if that ends up happening. But for the harvest and expenses log, which is going to be in the beginning of each monthly setup portion, I'm going to be writing down the months here, so I can just, you know, if I need to thumb through to find my expenses, that'll be quicker. Yeah, and then yearly maps, so if I'm doing succession plantings, I can just put in, you know, oh, I put it here, and then just draw it on the yearly map and be able to reference that. Yeah, and then I'll, you know, I'm gonna have the pest pages. In addition, I'm gonna have plant pages, so if there's some, you know, weird weed coming up, or I guess technically a weed could be considered a pest, but anyway, if there's like a weird annual that I didn't know about, you know, I can look it up and then draw it and put it in on a page and put it there. So here I'm starting off with having seasonality. So this is just like the information for particularly where I'm located. My 90% frost dates, two different sources for 50% frost dates and 10% frost dates. And then here I'm gonna have the actual frost dates for each year. So I've noticed that spring has been coming earlier every year. Like right now, I'd say it's definitely spring, and today's March 12th, and for me, it's totally spring already. It hasn't been, you know, hasn't been too cold, the snow's all melted, everything's warm during the day, so it's coming more and more early now. So I want to start recording that so I can pay attention to, over time with, you know, global warming, cough, cough, how erratic the seasons are becoming. And then I also have my zone information. I'm in zone 6A, and that's the temperature range for that. Then here we've got a couple different properties, so I wanted to have just a quick reference for each of the property maps. So here's the property map. We live up here. This is the farm map, which is at a different location where we have our greenhouses. And this is going to be my little garden map. This is blown up a lot because it fit perfectly with this little green doohickey here. But yeah, so this is the map that I'm actually going to be doing my gardening in. Then I have a page for seed sources, so that's going to be, it's going to be really simple, because I have done a seed source, I guess, chart that included the when I got them, like germination rates, and like the price per seed, and the price per packet, and oh, that was way too intensive to figure that out. And once I figure out what seeds I'm going to be you know, planting, I end up saving them the next year, so I really don't need to pay too much attention to that. Really, this is just gonna be me experimenting with different varieties of stuff. So it's gonna be the year I got the seed, the type, so like a broccoli, and the variety, the company, and the verdict, whether or not I liked it, and assorted different notes. So that goes there. Then plant gifts. So that's gonna be essentially all of the plants that my mom gives me. Because my mom is an avid gardener and she has lots of flowers, and I currently don't have any irrigation system set up, so I can't really plant too many right now. But I'm sure when the spring comes and I set up my kind of pseudo-permanent irrigation system, I'll be able to take some plants off her hands and plant them in my garden. So this is gonna be me recording them and, you know, what they are, where I put them, and the variety and whatnot. And I think that's about it. So with this, I'm going to be having, like I was saying, monthly setups where I explain a little bit about what my list is gonna be. I might end up doing this in with my normal bullet journal setup. So I can be like, oh yeah, here's my normal bullet journal setup and here's my garden bullet journal setup, but we'll see how that goes. But I am gonna have monthly setups. It's not gonna be nearly as intensive as my normal bullet journal setups because this isn't gonna have habits or anything like that. Yeah, I guess that's about it, guys. I'm really excited to get into this journal because I think this is going to help me stay on top of the tasks I need to get done and kind of track the seasonality, which is kind of something I've been worried about, you know? Yeah, going forward, I know this is definitely going to help me in the years to come. Anyway, if you guys like this video, please consider subscribing. I put out new bullet journal / farm videos every week, or almost every week. And if you guys enjoy these, you're going to enjoy the new content I'm putting out this spring. Anyway, I hope you guys have a really good beginning to your spring. I know I am. See you soon. Bye.